Today we are in step 7 of our 21 steps to Google Ads optimization series, and we are going to be talking about killing keywords. Let's get to it. Hi, I'm Mike Mancini with PPCVideotraining.com. Thanks so much for joining us. Today we are in step 7, and we're talking about keywords, and we're talking about killing keywords. Now, I know that sounds a little bit violent, but these keywords are not doing you any good, and we want to get rid of them. So which keywords are we talking about? I want you to go into your campaign, and I want you to click on the campaign itself, and then click on keywords. Once in here, make sure you're on the search keywords tab. These are keywords that you have added into your account. I'm not going to show you all of these because they're really not relevant, so that's why they're blurred out. And this is actually a client account, so that's another reason why. Once you're in here, I want you to go up and I want you to click on the dates, and I want you to go back a ways. So go back probably at least 6 months if you've been spending quite a bit. If not, go back a year. It's, you know, a good period of time. Or if you have not really touched your account in some time, even go back and look at it all time. Once you've got that figured out, I want you to click and I want you to sort by impressions. Let's scroll all the way down to the bottom and let's get as many of these on the same page as we can. So you can click on show rows. Let's just show 500 because we have 333 keywords in this account. Now I want to show you what we're talking about here. So I've sorted by impressions, and out of those 333 keywords that we have added to that account, only 99 of them even have impressions. That means the rest of these keywords are weighing the campaign down. Meaning they could be sitting in our ad groups and maybe they're not getting enough searches to trigger ads, which is obviously Google Ads 101. Pause those keywords, get rid of them. They could be of poor quality score and once again, bringing our ad groups down. Pause them, get rid of them. Or they could be not very focused and maybe the keyword has nothing to do with the rest of the keywords in the ad group. If it's a keyword that you absolutely need to have, then take it out and put it in its own ad group. But like I said, out of those 333 keywords, 234 of them have never gotten a click or even an impression. So as you can see, we have paused all of these keywords. This is obviously a campaign we've already done this with. But let's continue this on, shall we? Go back up to the top and sort by clicks. Scroll down until you do not see any clicks. And there, we've narrowed it down even further because we're talking about we out of those 333 keywords, only 85 of them even have clicks. So if I've gone back a year, maybe this one's had a lot of impressions, but it's never had a click. Guess what? It's gone. So I would go down and I would just highlight all of these and I would click pause. So what you need to remember is Google likes efficient ad groups. It likes to see ad groups that are very tightly knit with their keywords, that the ads are representative of all of the keywords in that ad group, and that the ad group is performing well. The better your ads perform, the cheaper it is for you. Google will actually give you a discounted price on your clicks if it's bringing people to pages and getting them to take action on what they're looking for. Having a bunch of dead keywords inside your ad groups just basically weighs it down. Think of it like a flower. If you've got a flower that's got 5 petals, but 4 petals on that are dead, chances are it's going to take the 5th one with it and kill the entire flower. However, if you take those 4 dead petals off, that one petal that's remaining now has a better chance of survival because the flower is using all of its nutrients and everything for that one petal. It's not trying to keep the other 4 alive anymore. I know that might be kind of a cheesy example, but hopefully it gets my point through. You want your campaign to perform well, and you start that by getting your keywords to perform well, getting your ad groups to perform well, and obviously then your whole campaign is performing well. but you have to start at the keyword level. And this is a way to do that. So go through and kill all of those non-performing keywords that are not getting any impressions or not getting any clicks. A lot of people will get freaked out by this because they're taking a look and saying, I have 333 keywords and I just got rid of 2/3 of them. What if somebody searches one of those? If somebody searches one of those keywords, chances are it revolves around one of your other keywords already in your ad group. Google knows this. And just because you don't have a particular keyword in there, if you go up and you click on search terms, those are what people are actually typing in. But as you can see, all of these have been added. But if I scroll down here, here's one that's not been added and it's gotten me 14 clicks. This is one that I have not added and it's gotten me 5 clicks. You get the idea. Google is showing our ads for keywords that we don't even have in our campaign. But Google knows that those keywords that people are typing in are related to what we have to offer. So they're showing our ads for keywords that we do not have in our campaign. This is where you want your keywords coming from, what people are actually searching in. If you go back here and you've got a bunch of keywords that you've put in that are not performing, get rid of them. Down below in the comments, let us know how many keywords you cleaned out of your account. Was it 10? Was it 20? Was it 1,000? Because we've gone into campaigns and literally cleaned out 2, 3, 4, 5,000 keywords in a campaign. And it was way too many keywords for what that person had budgeted. So let us know in the comments below, and we'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching our video. If you enjoyed it, please like and subscribe to our channel, or share our video with someone who might find it interesting. Or if you know someone who's in need of PPC or Google Ad services, please forward our information to them. We'd love to help. Thanks so much.